everybody. Welcome to Holiday World. My name is Brentley Craig. You can find me at the Lake City location. Today I'm going to do a walk around on one of Keystone's brands, the Springdale Mini. Springdale is one of the most popular brands that Keystone's had on the market for many, many, many years. This is a new floor plan out for this year. It's a 2010 bunkhouse. We're starting in the front of the unit. Your crank up and down for putting it on and off the hitch of your truck, 20-pound propane bottle, and your battery store right behind it. If you follow me this way, we're just going to point out that almost all Keystone products come solar ready. What that means basically is that we have a location on the top of this unit where you can put a solar panel that's already prepped for that, and it just plugs in, or you can put one that plugs in here that's remote. Okay, this is your pass-through. It goes from side to side. As you can note in here, plenty of opportunities to store some of your lawn chairs and some of the items, some of your tools that you might want to carry with you. As we move across the side, you'll see that this particular unit has an awning. It's an electric awning, just the push of a button to come out and retract back in. It does have an LED light strip with it. This particular awning is 10 feet in length and width. The Keystone Springdale also comes with the solid step system from LCI. We do have 110 power out here. A lot of times you'll find somebody wants to put a stereo out here, a blender, maybe a TV or something like that. You got full 110 power right at the sides. One thing to point out on this particular unit, guys, is we've taken the axles and we flipped them upside down, which allows us a lot more ground clearance. So if you are going to the deer lease, if you're going off-road, you're not going to have any problems with any of your plumbing up underneath. You've got all the ground clearance you need to get off-road on this particular unit. Also, as we come to the back, I've got a secondary additional underbelly underbelly storage, if you will. This is underneath the bunk in the back of the unit. As you can see, it's got plenty of options to put some more gear back there as well. And then finally, to the back of the camper, you've got some water inlets here, right next to your spare tire that's going to be bolted to the bumper of this particular unit. All right, guys. Now we're up inside the 2010 VH, the new floor plan from Keystone under the Springdale model brand name. I want to point out, when you come into your left, this is where you're going to find the switch to take your awning in and out, lights inside and outside. You're also going to have a water pump if you're pulling off your fresh water tank, as well as your water heater. You'll always want to turn your water heater on if you don't want to take a cold shower. Your tank indicator lights are all right here, and then a thermostat for your furnace is here as well. As you come in the coach to your right, you're going to have a queen size bed. It does offer some additional storage underneath the bed, as you'll find in most units. A little bit of storage over here for some hanging clothes or some folding clothes as well. You will find both 110 outlet and USB chargers at the head of the bed. A full shelf that goes from side to side, so you can put some additional gear up and out of the way in this particular unit. If we go over here to the right, we're going to step into the kitchen, if you will. I got a two burner cooktop made by Suburban, microwave from Greystone, and a little sink to kind of do some of your prep with. I do have a drawer for some storage, as well as some cabinet space down below. To your left, you're going to find a dinette that converts to some extra sleeping space. This table just folds down. The cushions come together to make another opportunity for somebody to sleep. All right, as we switch positions here, I want to show you some of the features that are in the back of the coach, starting with some additional storage above the dinette. If you will, some paper plates, cups, towels, dishes, you name it, can go right here. You're going to see in this particular unit, I've got two bunks. They are double-sized bunks in the rear of the coach. Okay, and down below is where you'll find the storage we showed you outside underneath that particular bunk. We have a 7-cubic-foot refrigerator. This particular refrigerator is made by a company called Dometic. Dometic's been making components for the RV industry for years and years and years. This is 7 cubic feet, and this particular refrigerator will be powered off of either electric or propane. It's a dual power system, okay? Right here is gonna be your furnace. If you are camping on a frigid night, that furnace will pull off the propane bottle that I showed you at the front of the coach. And then this is basically your fuse box and your breakers. You'll find a box that looks similar to this in about every coach that's out there. Basically a little pantry and some additional storage here for some of your groceries that are gonna make the trip with you. And then finally, guys, step into a full bath. Unlike a lot of trailers of this size, this trailer has a full shower separated from the toilet. This is not a wet bath type of a coach. So you have a shower, you have your toilet, and then your sink here with a little medicine cabinet above for some of your toiletries, as well as some storage below. One thing I want to share with you is the capacities on the tanks of this particular unit. This particular unit comes with 27 gallons of fresh water. If you wanted to camp where you weren't going to have access to water, you can load 27 gallons on board. And then your gray tank is going to have a 30 pound capacity, and your black tank is going to be 30 gallon capacity as well. This unit comes with a fully ducted AC unit. It's a 13,500 BTU unit, and the furnace is 20,000 BTU for camping on those frigid nights. Folks, I appreciate you spending some time with me. Again, my name is Brentley Craig. You can find me at the League City location for Holiday World, and I would encourage you to give us a call, 281-724-2050.